Hello learners, I am Dr. Sunita Sundrial. Welcome to NIOS Studio. Today we are going to study about components of management. This topic comes under paper 507, Community and Elementary Education, under the D.El.Ed program run by NIOS for distant mode students. Before we begin the main topic, let us look at the aims and objectives of components of management. The first aim is to know about the activities of management and then to understand the importance of analyzing, planning, and then organizing, implementing, and evaluating the whole process. First, let us see what actually management is. Management is the art of getting things done through people, as said by Mary Parker Follett. Kimball and Kimball state that management embraces all duties and functions that pertain to the initiation of an enterprise. Various activities form the components of matter. Kimball and Kimball further says that it's financing, the establishment of all major policies, the provision of all necessary equipments, the outlining if the general form of organization under which the enterprise is to operate, and the selection of the principal office all come under management. Now look at the image. What do you see, learners? Can you see that a hand is shown where various peoples are standing, and all those peoples are shown standing on a concentric circle? What do you think is happening in the picture? What is the concentric circle expressing? It shows that all the concentric circles limits the employees, and each circle is interconnected with the other one. That means all the employees are interconnected, and these employees are looked after and led by a leader. And the leader manages all the working of these employees. So management is where people are managed and various activities are sequentially arranged in a management. Let us now see what are those activities which are required for management. These activities which are required for management of any process, these activities are termed as components. For managing things, certain activities with different approaches are performed, and these are known as components. Let us now see what are those different components are. The first one is analyzing the position of institution. The analyzing institution means where manager is to be done. The manager looks after the situation, the surrounding, the environment, and after analyzing it, the next step is planning strategies accordingly. After planning the strategies, the next step is the organizing the various resources which may be used during management. The next component, a very important one, is the implementation of planned strategies. For managing certain environment, certain activities, strategies and approaches are planned and then they are applied. After applying the strategies, we have to see whether those strategies have been successful or not, and this can be tested by evaluating that how the strategies utilized have resulted. Now, learners, look at the chart which is shown before you. What do you see in the chart? The circle has been divided into four parts, starting with the plan block. What do you see? There are three components: policy, which are framed to be followed, objectives and aims to do a project, targets which are to be met after doing the project. And look at the next block, it is do block. It has also four components: structure, the working should be tailored, responsibility, that is who and how it will be carried by, training, that is to hone and polish the skill and do allotted job satisfactorily. Communication during the work is extremely important. Now learners, look at the third block, which is check, and it has four components too. Monitor and keep an eye on the working, record all the steps of functioning, measure to check the extent to which the success has been achieved, audit the whole process and procedure and performance. Now look at the fourth block, which is the act block, and it has two components. The two components are management and review. The overview of the whole process is done. And second one is continuous improvement by understanding the loopholes or drawbacks left in the first cycle. In this way, we can say the last block is the connecting link between the next management cycle, which is to be picked up. So learners, now we move on to another figure, which you can see in front of you. What do you see? The first image is a figure carrying a book and a lens. What do you think he is doing? Why are the papers strayed on the ground? What must be the man trying to find in the papers? Now glance at the second image. What is the man looking by the lens? What is he doing? Can you draw any conclusion? In the first image, the man is busy studying papers in detail and he is noting down it in the book. In the second image, he is looking at the people or the subordinates and studying them. He is looking for the talents, abilities and capacities of these people. He may be finding out certain people with some drawbacks or weaknesses, for example, as seen in the picture, the red figure. So in this way, the analyzing of situation is very, very important for management. Let us understand more about it. The analyzing of situation can be done by various methods. These various methods are observation of the situation. A good leader must observe and assess the vision of the organization. Second one is interviewing the related people directly or indirectly. Much of the information can be gathered by talking to the people who are engaged in the organization, inside or outside the campus. People are the best source of formal and informal information. Third one is discussion with the employee. The people who are employed there, working there, in-house working staff helps to gather many minute details. This may prove to be helpful. And fourth one is survey with the help of available resources, where informal or people which do not give complete knowledge about the institute or organization, the information can be collected by surveys. So therefore, whatever the methods utilized to collect the information, the aim is to assess the exact condition of the environment. After analyzing the situation, let us move on to another picture. The picture says quite a lot in its own. It expresses many things. As you see in the center is plan. The plan word is surrounded by many blocks. Let us consider an example where you are planning to take the children in your class for an outing. You make them understand the concept behind the outing. You explain the concept of the outing. Then you create a vision for them that why outing is necessary and why it should be taken for. Then you let the people think and discuss what should be done for the outing. The students then employ their creativity in suggesting sites. You may then evaluate the sites and understand which one will be good for the students. Thus, after evaluating the site, you can make the choice. You will then plan with the students about how long you need to visit, and you have to take the acceptance and permission from the principal. All are these to be planned. And you can also ask the senior teachers or experienced teachers about their experience or what should be taken care of. In this way, you can help the students by taking supervision from senior teachers. All this would need to be planned. Thus, role of plan is very, very important before beginning of any work or any project. The next component is planning strategies. Kuntz and O'Daniel state that planning is deciding in advance what to do, how to do, and who will do it. It bridges the gap from where you are to where you want to go. Hence, planning is a continuous process. Thus, planning is understanding which steps would be required to achieve our goals is the best possible manner. Everything should be decided in advance or beforehand in order to ensure that the procedures run smoothly and without any hitches. Planning the procedure beforehand also leaves no room for conflict or confusion. The entire energy of workers can go in actually performing or functioning. Managing an institution is not an easy task. It is an intricate procedure. So these procedures involved are the requirements of managing an institution. It involves determining course of action. that how the action will be taken, what steps will be taken, what will be the way or means to complete those actions. This step involves deciding the manner in which the things will proceed. It is the course which is chosen for appropriate task at hand. Another requirement is to visualize the goals, hurdles, and solution and be prepared for it. Setting the goals makes sure that we set the tone for the task. If you know beforehand the result we seek to attain, we will proceed with more attention to the aspects of the task that help in best achieving the decided goals. It will also help to predict the hurdles before the action and plan the solution for them beforehand. It helps everyone involved in the management to be prepared for anything that may be possible. And the third is the strategies adopted on the type of work one undertakes. Strategies depend on type of work like maintaining physical resources, human resources, achievements, etc. While planning is essential, the next element is equally essential. Let us see how this element figures in the management process. To understand this, let us see the image further. Now, this is a very interesting image, learners. What do you see in this image? On one side, there is Almira, which is very disorganized, and on another side, you see a very organized Almira. What do you think this tries to express? Can you realize why the contrast is relevant or important to what we will discuss? Which part of the picture attracts you more? The picture shows two arrangements of a shelf of clothes. The left side shows clothes thrown haphazardly on the shelf. It would definitely be more difficult to choose a cloth from this shelf to wear. Now look at the right side of the picture. The clothes are properly arranged and you can clearly take out whatever you need. It is very easy to select the clothes you are going to wear. Now let us understand how arranging things properly make our task easier. Arranging things, organizing things properly help to proceed in a task in a successful manner. Organization is the process of identifying and grouping work to be performed, defining and delegating responsibility and authority, and establishing relationship for the purpose of enabling people to work most effectively together in accomplishing objectives. These are the words stated by Louis A. Allen. Louis meant that the process of organization requires organizing a list of the tasks to be performed as a part of the entire process. The performers will be solely responsible for completing their task. These tasks should also be linked to each other in manner that people see the bigger picture and work in a way that the entire process is a success. It is after this that the resources required for each task are organized. And for this, the strategies include organizing ways and means to improve infrastructure. Now, how do we organize means for improving the infrastructure? The leader has to see, the subordinates have to see that what are the deficiencies or weaknesses which an infrastructure requires. Then they can be overcome. Organizing means to improve infrastructure done can be led to another factor, that is increasing academic as well as administrative achievement. For completing a certain task, one need to understand how the task will be best accomplished, that is to find the ways for this. Various resources may be needed. Thus, there arises a need to fill the gaps in the already existing infrastructure, academic and administrative structure. The performance of the participant needs to improve individually. Now, let us understand this in more detail by moving on to the next picture. What do you see in this image? Look at the picture carefully. What do you observe in it? Can you see the figures holding on the blocks in front of them? Can you guess why they are doing so? What do you think it means? The four blocks make a perfect square together. Can you see the four blocks? One is in red, green, blue, and fluorescent green. And they are arranged so beautifully that you can see it has taken the shape of a square. And this has been done with the cooperation and coordination of the four employees. Each figure is responsible for their block and contributes of making it into a whole. The square represents the whole task. Even if one of them leaves their block or fails to perform their duty, the entire structure or task will collapse. So you can understand how it is important to perform well in coordination for a smooth functioning. Let us discuss the implementation of strategies. Harbinayak and Joyce said, a process by which large, complex and potentially unmanageable strategic problems are factored into progressively smaller, less complex and hence more manageable proportion. So, Joy says that whatever strategies are thought of or planned should be implemented properly in an organized manner so that we can achieve what has been set as a goal. Whatever has been thought, planned and organized is put into practice. It includes that what is to be done, that assigning right people in the right job. That is, the people who are capable of doing whatever job is given that job only so that he can perform to his best. If wrong person is set at a wrong place, we will get a wrong impression, a wrong result, a negative result, and the plan or the work may fail. It also includes guiding and instructing people regarding the task they are assigned. After assigning the task and instructing them about the manner in which they ought to perform, it is also important to maintain their levels. The practicality also includes, instead of pushing them to be more and more efficient, the leader should be in effort into raising the morale of the performers. There should be constant encouragement from the side of the leader. Motivation will help them to perform better and better. Besides giving them motivation and boosting their morale, there should be proper coordination and integration in all the activities that are to be performed. All the activities form a part of the task that need to be interconnected and synchronized. They should be clear in what role they play towards achieving the final goals. Further, it is important to ensure that there is often open and comprehensible communication. That means the communication should be open, all should communicate with each other, they should share their ideas, suggestions, feedback, and this will help them to follow up the program, the strategies being implemented during management process. So, in this way, they understand what is their position, where they stand with regards to their efficiency and performance. Let us now look at the next component, but before that, let us observe the image. Very interesting concept. Learners, you must be using nowadays emoticons, that is smileys, in your mobile phones. And obviously, smileys express the feelings, what the person's emotions are, and how these are expressed can be seen in the first image of the slide. You can see a hand on one of the emoticons. What do you think it means? Look at the other picture. Why do you think the man's one hand is slightly raised over the other? The hand shown in the figure is clearly choosing the smiley face rather than the sad or straight face. This means the person has been satisfied with whatever experience or services she or he has received. Think of the several times you have been asked to rate food in a restaurant, a movie or a product on an online shopping platform. You choose a reaction based on your performance or on your experience. The other picture shows the man weighing something. He thinks that the thing he has been thinking about has more pros than cons, and thus he has the hand with the tick slightly raised than the one with the cross. Compare this when you evaluate the right and wrong of a choice, almost as if weighing the options in your mind. Let us understand, before doing a work, you think over it. Think what is right, think what is wrong, what will be the result of choosing a particular option, and how the wrong option can be devoid of. To find out more right and wrong, pros and cons, we need an assessment theory. We need to evaluate how the particular thing, a particular process, a particular strategy is good or will be successful for your management process. So, evaluating the strategies used. Now, first let us understand what is evaluation. According to Ellis, Freeman and Ross, a systematic, rigorous and meticulous application of scientific methods to assess the design, implementation, improvement or outcomes of a program, it is a resource-intensive process frequently requiring resources such as evaluate expertise, labor, time and a sizable budget. So, we can see that Evaluation is just finding out the whole gist of the process undergone to find out how the management process has occurred, how the results are, whether they are suitable or not, how they can be modified for better results in the next cycle. So these are the evaluation and how these strategies are used, we can see in further topic. The evaluation is done for the following: to assess whether the steps taken during management process are mentioned or planned or practiced sequentially or not. We have to see, did any strategy planned fail or fall short of expectation? Then we have to see, has there been any loophole in the implementation of the evaluation? We can pinpoint the problem. We can then modify it with ease and find the proper solution to avoid encountering any loopholes the next time. Evaluation is thus overall the process of finding or assessing whether things have been done properly, because the answer to what went wrong usually lies in the way things are done. In this way, we can find out any loophole in the implementation of our management process. And if any loopholes are found, they can be identified, and when identified, they can be seen why this has been seen as loophole, why the mistake has occurred, has there been any problem in using the strategy, or is there any problem with the strategy itself? Has there been anything wrong with the planning? So all these things can be modified when we move on for the next cycle. So evaluation is helpful in ensuring a 100% success rate the next time a task is performed. Evaluation can thus also help others performing similar tasks in future, as they will be aware of the problems they have faced. We are done with the discussion of the components of management now. You can now understand what are the various steps the management process includes, how the management goes. You started with the planning and ended with the evaluation. So moving on to the brief summary, learners, whatever has been studied, we can summarize into a capsule, and this capsule has been presented before you in the form of a chart. The top of the chart, you can see it is written strategy and planning. Here four basic steps have been given in the blocks, which are analysis, develop, execute and assess. As we have already discussed that in analysis, we have to analyze the idea, how innovation is to be done and how we can refresh the things. In the second step, we went to the development, that means how after analyzing the process has to be developed, and for development of the process, the first thing and foremost thing is the planning. And you have studied, I have told you earlier, that what planning plays in during the management process. After planning, the actual implementation occurs only when the process has been started, and the process starts with the organizing of various resources like the material resources and the that is the physical resources and the human resources, that is the people involved, the subordinates, the colleagues, the staff, etc. When the sources have been organized, we move on to another step, which is the execution of our plan, which we have planned the strategies, the resources, everything. Now execution or implementation or the practical aspect has come, and in this practical aspect, we roll out whatever has been planned and organized. Everything has been executed, the work has been implemented, the process has been gone through. Now comes the last step, which is the assessment or evaluation of the whole management process. This can be done by reviewing what has been done, how it has been done, whether it has been successful or not. If it is successful, how it can be made much more better. If it has not been, then find out the loopholes and overcome those weaknesses, those limitations and drawbacks, and then after overcoming these limitations, we can move on to another cycle with a better prospects, with better goals and with better success rate. So I hope you have understood what is the management and components of management today. This is all for today's lecture. Hopefully you have understood the components of management. Thank you.